tribute to all my fallen brothers. Tell me how far we truly grown. We went from the plantation fields to burning crosses in front of our home. We went through periods of segregation, quote unquote, separate but equal. They put holes in our education, just another way to beat you. They end segregation, find another way to defeat you. Standardized testing, they renamed it and reshaped it, still minimize our education, they just found a new way to save it, just a new way to play it. Let's explore how many lives lost due to Jim Crow laws. Let's just name one. Emmett Till, 14-year-old boy who put him in your son. August 1955, they said he broke a Jim Crow law and felt he needed to die for whistling at a white woman in the grocery store. So when is enough enough? When do we say no more? 1999, Amadou Diallo shot dead in his door. 41 shots fired with just his wallet in his hand. So when do we as a people stand up and take a stand? We need to get out of this out of sight, out of mind mentality. It's going to be a long fight to end racial profiling and police brutality. We need to understand for every new day brings a new age, warrants unjust attacks to attack us in a new way. We need to stop looking for instant gratification. This illusion that the struggle is over is just a figment of our imagination. For every new cut is a new abrasion, a new tragedy. Sean Bell, 23-year-old male, shot dead in his car. 50 shots fired because the soldiers went to sleep at war. Cameras running around, we didn't feel no need to fight anymore. Once again, my people went to sleep like everything was all good, and they snuck up on us like a thief in the night and killed Trayvon because he had on the hood. We let these racial profiling tactics slip through the crack, because when they was pointing fingers, generalizing our kids, we didn't fight back. They told us that every black man who walked the streets with do-rag tins in the hood must be looking for trouble. He must be up to no good. So we ran home and talked to our daughters and sons and told them the way the world worked and how things ought to be done and how they should present themselves when they enter into society. But it's a lie, you see, because we can take away their do-rags, their hoodies, and their tins. They still go walk around in their God-given skin. Can't run from that. Can't hide that fact. We can dress it up any way they want. They still gonna be black. Every brother that I mentioned in this poem was killed because he was a black man. So they could flip it and they could spit it any way they want. It was dark. I couldn't see. I thought he had a gun. No, it was dark. He was scared. That was his wallet in his hand. 41 shots fired. You were just a fire if he killed that man. Oh, I was scared. He had a hood. He looked suspicious in the rain. He is a child. He is gone. And you will never understand his mother's pain. He wasn't out looking for mischief. He came from a proud black family. You gunned my brother down on the way home from buying candy. Then you take the law and you twist it and you tweak it and find loopholes for barbaric animals like Zimmerman could beat it. And we sit back and we take it, go to rallies and we fake it till the cameras power down and we seem to lose our rage like it was all just a facade, like we was going through a phase. These are our fallen brothers. We must never let them forget our pain. If we don't bond together in unity, this will continue to happen to our people. Nothing will ever change except the victim's name. Thank you, y'all.